Good morning, YouTube. So, got two things we're going to do today. The first one is, see that? That right there is my State of Texas registration and inspection sticker, and it's going to expire next month.
Oh, no!
Oh, no!
Oh, no!
Oh, no!
Oh, no!
Oh, yeah!
I'm going to go take it to my buddy's place, and he's going to inspect it and get it so it's still road legal.
My lord, is that legal?
I will make it legal.
The second thing is actually about the Mini. So Scott Snyder, who works at Mini of Austin, he's a super big Mini fan, and he invited me to come. I think there's like a Mini Club of Austin, and they're going to run their cars on the dyno today. So he was like, hey, you should come out, bring the Ferrari or bring the Mini or something. Since I'm already going to be out in the Ferrari, I'm just going to head out there in the Ferrari, plus the excuse to drive a Ferrari. But it's like 30 miles out of town. It's in Hutto. It's not in Austin. I'm kind of curious what these Minis can pull on the dyno, so that'll be kind of cool. Let's go see some Minis running the dyno, see what sort of numbers they're throwing down. I think it'll be fun. So we're going to go do that, get inspected, go see some dyno stuff, and enjoy a good day because it's supposed to be like actually not stupid hot today. Like only supposed to get to 92. When you've had like 105 for a while and then you go down to 92, you're like, this is great. Oh my God. Like, what kind of wonderful weather? And normally you'd be like, 92. Let's get rolling and have a sweet day. All right, just passed inspection. Woo. So now I'm gonna go drive another 25 miles out to Hutto. Go check out this Mini Cooper Dyno Day for a little bit. I mean, yeah, why not, right? Let's see some Minis. I didn't know if you guys know this, but this is electric. This is electric. Yeah, they make an electric Mini Cooper. I had no idea. Here we go, round two. I think the first one they said it pulled 145, 155, or 145, one something, so here we go. So, that's Scott. He invited me here today. This is called Vitronic. It's out in Hutto. That's where we are. So they have a Mustang dyno, all-wheel dyno. I think it might be one of the only, or I think it's only one or two all-wheel dynos in town. So they specialize in like Minis, BMWs, Audis. So they seem to know what they're doing, and I need to get my wife's car out here to get a tune on it, but somehow I gotta do that without telling her crap, and she might watch this, so I shouldn't have said that.
I tried to use a 93 shell because I can hear a little bit of the ping. If I can hear it with my ear, then it's
okay.
Do it more.
Cool. Yeah, my bad.
God, don't buy that shit gas.
No more Valero gas.
Yeah, it's got to be intercooler radiator.
That's the turbo?
Yeah, giant turbo.
That's the turbo and that's the intake, right?
Yeah, intake side. Yeah. Do you know what the hell that is?
It's his bypass valve, blow off valve.
It is his blow off? Okay.
Big valve.
Yeah. I thought, I was like, I just never seen one shaped like that. It's just a really,
it's a strange. It could be a marital aid, I guess, too.
Marital aid?
Yeah.
But make whee, noises.
Yeah.
The little eyes.
Oh, my airbrush on there.
That's cool. What'd it run?
205 horse and 280 torque.
2.8?
Yeah, it's got a stage 2. It's got a stage 2 tune in.
All right, so that Mini just ran 195 horse, which they say is 205 with the weather correction, and 280 foot-pounds of torque. A lot of torque. I'm actually impressed with the torque number. So just talking to him, he said, if I brought my wife's Mini here, he thinks it'd probably pick up about 30, 35 horsepower, probably around 50 foot-pounds of torque. And he said they'd do it for like $500. Meg, go away. Go, don't watch this part, okay? We're gonna do this shit. Somehow we're gonna make it happen, all right? It's between you and me, not Meg.
Clutch slipping.
Ooh, they said the clutch was slipping. You can see the RPMs jumping. Yeah, 214, 208. So I think they convinced me to put the Ferrari in the dyno. All right. They twisted my arm, like, ah! Strapped down. This always makes you a little nervous, but it'll be fine. We gotta move around the blowers, so it's kind of hard because there's a radiator on each side of the front, and then the intakes are on each side on the behind the doors. So you need four fans, kind of pain in the butt. So having done this before, waiting. All right. So I was saying, having done this before, I know to stand in front of the car, not behind the car, because I like my ears working. Yeah, I know.
My friend Johnny had the newer one, so I'm using
that. Oh,
yeah,
one. Yeah, the new one's push.
Yeah, it's like we're hitting on it.
Yeah, this is kind of like, hey, look at the button. I don't know how we're gonna make it work, but look at the button.
They try to make you feel like
you're like, ooh, it's a race car.
Yeah. This is a nice car. Very nice car.
Well, crap. We were all set to go, and then the rear diffuser actually touches the rollers. You know, because they actually, like, once they get it ready to go, you heard that air sound. It lowers the car onto the rollers. Well, then the damn diffuser touched the rollers. So now we gotta pull off the diffuser. Bah. There we go. All right, and there we go. I'm gonna stand over here so you can see their faces and watch them plug their ears.
I need the vapors.
Yeah. Thank you, Mama.
The show is camp or something? Or?
No, no, it's up near 210. It'll come back down in a.
Yeah, it's one of the.
As it idles a little.
Yeah, then it idle a little bit. I'm gonna just shut it right off.
Yeah, it's probably. Yeah, I mean, just it's just not enough air. Wonder if that's the flywheel.
They say Mustangs are heartbreakers, right? The Mustang dynos read low. And I got 350 horsepower, and 307, so about 310 foot-pounds of torque. So, not too bad. It's all right. It's, for a Mustang dyno, that seems about right. It's about 90 horsepower lower or so than it was on the dyno jet.
What type of motor is this?
Is this an N14 or N16?
N18.
Oh, it's an N18?
I was telling him it's enjoyable to have someone else see the pain I have to go through every time I pull that damn thing off to fix the fucking exhaust valves.
Oh, it's just a wee little turbo. It is pretty small.
Yeah.
Jeez. Is that like 50 millimeter?
Not even.
Not even?
Yeah, compared to the big dog on the shelf over there.
Yeah, jeez.
Yeah, but these, they'll get so hot, the plastic valve cover melts.
Oh, no thanks.
Got 170, it's pretty good. Bytronic, awesome guys here in Hutto, so close to Austin. If you need to get a tune, talk to them, they'll hook you up. Also, I gotta give a big thanks to Scott Schneider. Scott, thank you for inviting me today, it was a lot of fun. Scott helps organize the Mini of Austin groups, like stuff. Also, he works for Mini of Austin, so if you got a Mini, you might actually already know Scott. Really nice guy, super nice guy. I think that's gonna do it for today. I need to go do other stuff. But you guys are amazing. Thanks for watching. Subscribe, watch the video, and thumbs up. Share this video. And tell me if you wanna see more stuff with cars other than Ferraris. I mean, know, sometimes, like, I'm always doing Ferrari stuff. Maybe you want to see some other non-Ferrari stuff. So, all right. We'll see you soon. It's going to be sweet. All right, so I already wrapped up the video at the dyno shop, and as I got home, actually it's a couple hours later because I filmed my thoughts again and I flubbed it again and recorded it in slow-mo. So I'm filming it for the third time. Here's what I wanted to say is Ferrari put down 360 horsepower, but when I previously dynoed it, it put down 450. And so why is there a discrepancy? Well, when I dynoed it the first time and it got tuned, that was on a dyno jet, and dyno jets are known to be fairly accurate. And this time I put it on a Mustang dyno, which let's just say Mustang dynos have a reputation of being heartbreakers, right? You don't get good numbers out of it, but they do a great job of tuning. So I don't know if it's something about how the Mustang puts a load on the car and the dyno jet doesn't. I think the actual real numbers are closer to the 450. It makes sense because the car has 490 at the crank from the factory. So with the tune and with the modifications I have, that should put the crank horsepower somewhere around 550, 540, which means the wheel horsepower should be right around 450, given the transmission and other parasitic loss. That's the theory anyway. Huge thanks to Scott Snyder. Thank you for inviting me. I had one hell of a fun time. And to the Mini Club for inviting me. And also a huge thanks to Bytronics for dynoing the car. You guys are awesome. They seem to know their shit, so if you guys have a BMW, an Audi, or a Mini, and you want to get tuned and you're in the Austin area, go look them up. Their info is right here. Hit them up, tell them I sent you, and your car's gonna be faster. I mean, come on, that's what we all want. You guys are amazing. Thank you for watching. Subscribe, watch, thumbs up, share, all that good stuff. If you want to see more stuff with Mini Coopers, let me know, we can make that happen. If you want to see me modify the car, don't tell Meg, I want to put it on the dyno and get it tuned. She's in the room. Shit, the plan may be foiled. All right, I'll see you guys soon. We'll do more car stuff. It's gonna be sweet.